ever wonder why albuterol can open your airways in seconds, propranolol can calm your racing heart? The secret lies in how these drugs interact with their receptors, something called intrinsic activity. Let's simplify this so it finally makes sense. Now, receptors are proteins that drug bind to. Think of a receptor like a faucet. When a drug binds, it's like turning the handle, but not every drug turns it the same way. Intrinsic activity is the ability of a drug, once bound, to produce a response. It determines drug ability to fully or partially activate the receptor. It's about effectiveness, not binding strength. Think of it this way. Just like a faucet controls the flow of water, consider the faucet as our receptor, and the drug is the hand turning it. When the faucet is turned all the way on, water flows at full strength. This is like a full agonist. It gives maximum activation and maximum response. When the faucet is left completely off, no water comes out, that's an antagonist. It gives no activation and as a result, no response. But if the faucet is only turned halfway, the water flows partially, that's a partial agonist, causing a partial activation and a partial response. Now, imagine the faucet doesn't just stay off, but actually sucks water back. That's an inverse agonist. It reduces receptor activity below its normal baseline, producing the opposite effect of an agonist. So, just like a faucet can be fully on, fully off, or somewhere in between, drugs can fully activate, block, or partially activate receptors. Now, full agonists bind to the receptor and produce the maximum biological response possible, mimicking the response to the endogenous ligand. All full agonists for a receptor population should produce the same Emax, and its intrinsic activity equal to 1, which is the highest response to be achieved. Partial agonist does activate the receptor, but not fully like a full agonist, and so, even if all the receptors are occupied, partial agonist cannot produce the same Emax as a full agonist. Partial agonist Emax will always be lower than a full agonist Emax, and its intrinsic activity between 0 and 1. Regarding affinity, the partial agonist could be greater than, lower than, or equal to the full agonist. We will explain what affinity means in details in another video. What will happen if a partial agonist and a full agonist presented at the same time for a receptor? If the partial agonist bind first, it will prevent full activation by a stronger agonist. And we say that the partial agonist acted as an antagonist of the full agonist. Now, what would happen to the Emax of a receptor saturated with an agonist in the presence of increasing concentration of a partial agonist? As the number of receptors occupied by the partial agonist increase, the Emax would decrease until it reached the Emax of the partial agonist. Now, the inverse agonist does reverse the activity of receptors and exert the opposite pharmacological effect of agonist, with intrinsic activity of less than 0. The antagonist does bind to the receptor but with no activation and no effect, blocking the receptor, preventing agonist from working. Since it doesn't produce any effect, it has an intrinsic activity equal to 0. Quick recap. Agonist causes full activation with intrinsic activity equal to 1. Antagonist causes no activation with intrinsic activity equal to 0. Partial agonist causes moderate activation with intrinsic activity between 0 and 1. Inverse agonist reduces receptor activity below its basal level with intrinsic activity of less than 0. In this curve, we have dose in logarithmic scale on the x-axis and the corresponding response on the y-axis. And as shown, we have the full agonist in orange with intrinsic activity equal to 1, a partial agonist in blue, plateau below the Emax of the full agonist, and intrinsic activity between 0 and 1. As expected, at 0 response, we have the antagonist, represented in green. And below 0, we have the inverse agonist shown in yellow. Alright, quiz mode on. Let's see if you got it. Question number 1. Which of the following statements about intrinsic activity is correct? A, B, C, or D? Question number 2. Buprenorphine is a partial agonist at opioid receptors. What does this mean? A, B, C, or D? If you learned something cool today, smash that like button and hit subscribe for more bite-sized medical lessons. Drop your answers and questions in the comments. Until next time, stay curious.